My name is Steven Su. I'm the CEO of Asian Resonated Felt Sungai Bahar. Our company specializes in heat and acoustic insulations material, which is called felt, supplying to automotive industry and aircon industries. We have been in this industry for more than 30 years. Okay, and our clientele that we serve include Sugihara, Paragon Grand Carpets, Hirotaco, who's the first tier supplier to OEM brand like Honda, Toyota, Proton, Perdua. Okay, and for the auto, aircon industry, we mainly supply to this Daikin, who also do export for the export markets. The RA is, we have been pondering about RA for quite a long time, and we are very supportive to the government's initiative and appreciate the government initiative to start off with this RA for the industrial 4.0, because moving forward, as everybody knows, that the cost of labor is increasing and there's a shortage of labor as well in the whole global industry. And to compete, to be competitive in the manufacturing side, we need to do a lot of automations, and machineries and automation is the only way to go to compete in the world market, as the machine are able to provide us precisions and also to able to control the cost of manufacturing. IR 4.0 will definitely help us to save a lot of labor costs and to make us to be more competitive in the world market, in the manufacturing, to export to world markets for the our products. This would also help us the in long runs to be more competitive and solve a lot of our labor issues, which we foresee it's going to be only become more and more difficult to get labor workers, and the cost is, you know, just continuously will be keep increasing. If we have automations and using machinery, so we can look into more precisions, and a lot of sensors, all these machineries are become more cheaper, so we can incorporate all this automation and machinery mechanisms into our manufacturing process. First is bring down our labor cost. Second thing is also help us to improve our quality and consistency. Labor issues, as Malaysia is moving towards more to developing country, and a lot of graduates, a lot of workers come out from the industries. I think the workers willing to work in the labor side, more moving towards more white collar, not so much on the blue collar. All the manufacturing are facing same issues of hiring workers. Yeah. So with this situation, and a lot of graduates now tend to be like, you know, a lot of engineers graduated. So we can make use of their expertise, which is in the engineering side, to go into our factory to improve our manufacturing system, to be upgraded to industrial 4.0. You know, automations, mechanize the processes, improving using machinery to compete in the market rather than using labor to compete in the market. Definitely, Industry 4.0 will come in helping us saving costs in the in processes in the more labor intensive area, which is our felt line. We have a machine which is 30 years old, so there's a lot of space area that we can improve with upgrading the systems. So the engineer, in fact we have three engineers now who specialize on upgrading the machineries and incorporating RR4 into our machineries. So in area like felt line, normally we when we input our resin into our machines, so we need to use one labor workers to input and the resin and pour them into the bin. So with the our initiative is to use a pumping system with a mixing system and a pumping system automatically, do it by yourself and pump into the bin so that all the resins are being contained properly and we can save one manpower there. The next section is the brushing side, because we are using conveyor belt and metal conveyor belt to through the ovens to press and to coat our this felt material. And after each processes, we need to do a lot of cleanings on the belt. So with the auto brushing system, with the stainless steel brush, and it can automate to brush it rather than using a scrap, which last time we need 4 persons to do scrapping, but now we don't need. We can save 4 manpower cost there. So this is part of the initiative we have moved forward and we have done to upgrade the machinery. Other than that, at the end line, which is currently we have 2 persons who are doing the receiving and the stacking of the finished goods material. On that part, we actually moving forward, we are looking into how to have an auto stacking system whereby we can save 2 more manpower on that area. Yeah, and also the scrap that came out from the machines, we want to do auto recycle back into the system. Currently, we have to take out and recycle at one section and bring it back into the machine to complete the whole cycle. Yep. That total can save us about easily 7 or 8 people. For IRA 4.0 is the only way to go for futures. As everybody, you know, we are the manufacturer as well. I believe we are facing the same issues, which is labor issues and manufacturing consistency, improving our quality. I would like to highlight is that would really appreciate the government's initiative to support our industries with grants and IR4, because it's a great vision, it's the right vision and the right directions to move forward with IR4. And we as an SME company, we really need government support and really appreciate that, you know, government have taken up this initiative to move forward our industry to IR4.